Welcome to the Rec Center. I'm Drew, here to give you our predictions for the top 10 movies in the box office this weekend. And we're going to start off with number 10 at The First Purge, hoping to get $2.1 million this weekend. Coming in at number 9, we have Jurassic World The Fallen Kingdom, hoping to raise up $5 million. And coming in at number 8, we have Dwayne The Rock Johnson scaling skyscrapers for $5.2 million. And coming in at number 7, we have Disney Pixar's Incredibles 2, hoping to have yet another incredible hold at $7 million. And coming in at number 6, we have Ant-Man and the Wasp, hoping to buzz their way to $9 million. Now, I know there's no bees in it, but I mean, wasps buzz a little bit when they get near you. Now we're going to jump into the top 5 for this weekend. And coming in at number 5, we have Hotel Transylvania 3, hoping to suck $12.3 million out of the box office this weekend. Now, at number 4, we have a new release of the Teen Titans Go to the Movies. Now, this is a movie based around Teen Titans Go the TV series, which is a Cartoon Network original series. And when looking at comps for this, it was kind of difficult. So, first we looked at Lego Ninjago Movie. I get it. It's part of the Lego Movie franchise. It also came out at a different time of the year. But Lego Ninjago was also a cartoon on Cartoon Network before it was a movie. So when looking at it, it opened up to around $20 million at a $5,000 per theater average, which isn't terrible. Then we also looked at Kubo and the Two Strings. We only looked at it because it was a standalone movie, basically. And basically what that means is that it's not part of a sequel or a bigger part of a bigger franchise. So, and it also appeals to both adults and kids, just like the Teen Titans Go to the Movies. So Kubo and the Two Strings opened up around $12 million at a $3,800 per theater average. So we feel as though that Teen Titans Go will fall around that area of the per theater average. So at number 4, we have Teen Titans Go to the Movies opening around $13 million. Now coming in at number 3, we have Equalizer 2 hoping to make an amount equal to $16 million this weekend. And coming in at number 2, we have Mamma Mia 2 hoping to sing its way to $18 million. And now coming in at the number 1 movie this weekend, we have it, you probably guessed it, we have it, Mission Impossible Fallout. Now this is the 6th movie in the Mission Impossible franchise, and when looking at comps, we looked at the last 2 Mission Impossible movies. Now let's just say Ghost Protocol is not the best comp to look at. It came out to only 400 theaters, so it had a soft opening, and when it did open wide, it was only open to $44.1 million at around $13,000 per theater average, which isn't the best. It also came out 7 years ago, so it's dated, and it came out during Christmas time, which summer and winter are two totally different seasons. And I'm not just saying that because it's my opinion. That's scientific fact, everybody. Now, we also looked at Rogue Nation, Mission Impossible Rogue Nation, which came out in the summer of 2015. It exploded to $55.5 million, which is the second best opening for any Mission Impossible movie, which was the second one that opened to $57 million. So with this uptick of a $14,000 per theater average, we feel as though Mission Impossible Fallout is just going to ride that wave and ride that uptick. So we feel as though Mission Impossible Fallout is going to be the number one movie getting $63 million this weekend. But that's our numbers. What do you think? Leave it in the comments section below. And while you're down there, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. And if you want to see our main video for this weekend, click this video right here. And if you want to see us in a funny skit, click down here. But that's it from us. Good luck this weekend. And remember, sometimes you gotta risk it to get that biscuit.